It's a pitch black night, with the light sun rising.
Okay, this is predicated on the idea that if you go to a movie, the director and the camera person already decided what you want to see. You never know.
The pioneer dogs, dressed in black and crouched low.
Okay.
Morning mist lingers. In anticipation,
I mean,
is in the air.
There's nothing out there. There is something outside the frame, but you.
Easy on that paddle. Don't make too many splashes.
What's in the narrative?
It'll be a miracle for them if they find us with our black faces and our black painted canoes and never find us. It's a brilliant bit of soldiering, I must say.
This is from Rosemary McDonald. If you don't shut up, I swear I'm going to kill you before the French do. Well, Rosemary.
Sorry, sir.
We're approaching the fall.
Got breath. Got breath. Make sure we don't float right past that fall.
What is this bloody awful stench?
That's the stench of 500 men living in cramped living conditions for months at a time.
If you don't like me, why come and find me? I mean, here's the thing about me. Okay. Let's see.
Paddles out. A crunching noise is heard as the canoes slide up onto the beach.
Move the point of view, giving the control of that point of view to one person.
And everyone jumps out. It's a crunching noise.
Give the control to that person, because I'm going to try. Okay, well, I think the easiest thing for me to do is to show you some material.
Another French soldier walks up next to the other two.
I mean, you can do it.
He asks them something in French, then orders it away. The soldier pulls out a cigar, lights it, and begins to smoke.
It doesn't really work out, though. You end up having to vote.
I just start watching The Price is Right, because you and your family.
Okay,
well, I don't know if it's going
to
work.
Another French soldier walks up next to the other two. He asks them something in French.
I've never seen it.
The soldier pulls out a cigar, lights it.
I just think it's part of American
And I'm walking around, maybe I'm wearing like a funny hat, and you're looking for somebody to shoot to, like, you know, you see me, I come to, and you think, oh, that person's interesting, you draw a bead on me.
I love it, and Frank.
See, what I do is I come in here,
talking to real people,
and I walk maybe 180 degrees around the circle, and I go out here.
For me, but I don't
and then
know
character
right
B
that.
Probably comes in here, and he's he
right.
Everybody sort of comes in, goes 180 degrees, and then they exit.
Now,
what might also happen is,
you. Okay.
You may, there may be two worlds, two circular worlds, an urban and a desert, and you may be able to get one to the other by following this dog.
Looks
like five men and one dog. That's six. So here I am, I'm going.
The fighting almost completely dies off. Silence ensues.
A path around the circle here, and you're probably following me, but
panting bloody men rest
against
the
walls,
drinking from the canteens.
But maybe you get distracted along the way, maybe you're looking at that naked
person over
there. But I'm sort of in a hurry, I gotta catch
my train. Having a clear view of the courtyard, they can see where the swath of bloodshed cut.
Here we go.
The corpses mark the path we took. Look, from the door to the bell, to the barracks. The ground is red. The ground is actually red.
Just care for a smoke, sir?
No.